Friends, can you hear me?
Yes.
All of you?
Yes, sir.
One thing I find, all of you smiling.
That's because you're here.
You know, smiling is a fantastic thing. You know about it? The smile, if you smile, the whole day will be smiling. If you don't smile, they will not smile. So it's like, make it a habit to smile. It creates a lot of friendship, a lot of happiness, okay?
Now, okay. You smile, but you also ask some tough questions.
No, they will ask me, don't worry. They will ask me for that.
Just to want to introduce you to all our audience around the country and around the world. Mr. Abdul Kalam, Dr. Abdul Kalam, one of India's most popular presidents. Would you say so?
Yes.
He was the president.
He was.
Correction.
Should he still be the president?
Yes.
Would you like to still be in the president?
So already we are a democratic country. Naturally, a process has gone through. Now I'm very happy what I am doing.
You're relaxed.
I got a plate full. Like these young people, I'll be teaching them, doing research, or very interesting things I'm going to do, okay?
Did you enjoy the presidency while it was there?
Oh, beautiful years, 5 years, beautiful years.
So 5 more beautiful years would have been nice.
Now, I want to talk to you something, okay? You are coming from different schools, Delhi,
colleges.
You are all from Delhi College.
Yes.
But from different parts of the country.
Uh-huh.
You are studying
okay.
here.
That's okay. So from Delhi College, right?
Various colleges in Delhi.
I want to ask you, all of you, my email is apj.abdulkalam.com, okay?
apj.abdulkalam.com.
apj@abdulkalam.com. Okay, that's my my website, www.abdulkalam.com, okay? Now, one question I'm going to ask you. All of you, at least few of you should respond. The first question, what I will be remembered for? What? Repeat it. What? What I will be remembered
for?
Who
wants to answer that?
No.
At the back there, she wants to answer that question.
Okay, okay.
One second, just the girl in the blue, yes. What will Dr. Kalam be remembered for?
Not me. Each one of you.
Oh, each one of you.
Each one of you.
Okay.
Not Kalam, and you don't worry about Kalam.
Okay, both things. What will you be remembered?
Each one of you. What, that question I put forth, what I will be remembered for?
Each one of you.
Each one, what I will be remembered.
Okay,
will you be remembered? I will give you some sort of indication. Will you be remembered as a great scientist, say, Thomas Alva Edison, who gave a meaning to the electricity? Or will you like to be remembered like our Sir C.V. Raman, who was a Nobel Prize winner for physics? Or will you like to be remembered as a mathematician who was Srinivasa Ramanujan, number 3, who gave to the India? Or would you like to remember like Einstein E=mc², he discovered today, it made a lot of difference to the life of human beings. So something you must cling to that. After all...
Sir, can I just ask you, all these things are great. What happens if you're just remembered as a good human being?
No, let them say that. Let them say that.
Okay, the young girl there.
Yeah, exactly.
What will you be remembered for, and what will Dr. President, ex-President Kalam be remembered for?
Professor.
Professor.
Good evening, sir.
Yes.
Sir, I'm Mehjubin Hussain. Sir, I would love to be remembered as someone who gave her all for her motherland.
All for her motherland.
Whatever I have given it for my motherland. I would be Excellent. Really remembered.
You're a fantastic girl.
And sir,
anyone of you.
She's got a second point.
Sir, you would be remembered as a person who is the best example of simple living and high thinking. Very, very high thinking. Yeah.
Simple living and high thinking.
We wish you all the very best, a long and a very long life and good health, because India does need people like you.
Thank you.
Professor Kalam, you've got an answer to the question.
I would be like to remembered as like through my writings, because I'm into creative writing. So I would want to shake up all the issues that are lying dormant in India and try to awaken people and increase their awareness. And
then you should join NDTV.
Definitely, I'm all for it.
Okay, and
no, writer is a beautiful mission.
Beautiful mission.
Yes, go ahead.
And you, sir, will be remembered for teaching us how to dream, and that dreams transform into thoughts, and thoughts transform into
beautiful.
Actions. That is really motivating.
Well, so this side is silent. This side is silent.
Yeah, this young lady here in the front, with the headband. Yeah, go ahead.
Good evening, sir. I guess you'll be remembered for the most straightforward scientific politician.
I'm asking you.
She called you a scientific politician.
Most straightforward scientific politician.
Yes.
And I think I'll be remembered as a good social activist.
Social activist. Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. Beautiful. Very nice. Men folk is silent. Yes. Just here in the front row,
in the black and white.
Yes.
Yeah. Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
My name is Harsh.
Yeah.
I think I'll be remembered as the greatest friend a person can have.
Oh, greatest friend?
Yes.
That's lovely.
Beautiful. Something unique.
And I think you'll be remembered as the most non-controversial president India ever had.
We're here in the residence where Professor Kalam is going to stay. You can see it's under renovation. I must give you a little anecdote of what happened today. It was pouring with rain all day. So we said, Professor Kalam, this is going to be very difficult to have the program today. And he said, I'm a scientist. I tell you, it will not rain. And it hasn't rained. So you're a meteorologist also.
I'd like to be.
Ask your question again.
That question.
I would like you to ask that whether the vision for India 2020, that it will become a superpower, will it be realized taking the present conditions of India into
mind. I got your question. But you know, first of all, it's not Kalam's vision. You said Kalam's vision 2020. It's a national vision. A nation which does not have a vision. Many civilizations collapsed because that civilization does not have a vision. So vision is a very important for national development, and India has the vision India 2020 to transforming India into a developed nation. Now, what does it mean? It means we are billion people. About 220 million people are below poverty line. So the aim is, if you push up these 220 million people from the poverty line, then definitely a developed India, economically developed India will come. You are asking, is it possible? The one of the tool we have to have is GDP, gross domestic product, economic growth. He's a big economist. He's a PhD in economy. My friend.
You're a better economist, actually.
So that 10% GDP growth is feasible. Our finance minister says we are at 9%. So if we have a 10% GDP growth and maintain it for a decade, definitely the economically developed India is possible. But now you can ask me, what are the tools? What are the tools we have? That's the question is there. The tools, we have identified five areas. Agriculture, agro-food processing. We should work on agro-food processing, you know? Second one, education and healthcare combined. Education for women folk. For particularly women education is the highest priority. Wherever in our country women education has been done, that state has got a healthy state, and also it has got small families emerged. So that's why we combined education, healthcare together. Third thing, our core competence, that is information and communication technology, we are doing very well. Then the most important infrastructure developments. Fifth area, self-reliance in critical technology. Now, what is the self-reliance critical technology? For example, 1998, when India became nuclear weapon state, what happened? What happened? India became 1998. India became a nuclear weapon state. What happened?
Sanctions.
Eh? Sanctions. That is the economic. Yes, you are right. Economic sanction was there, and also technological sanction. But because
so
our farmers,
when nuclear state, are you in favor of the bomb?
No, India became a nuclear weapon state means everything is there. You generate the power, the
yes,
electricity
but,
you generate.
The bomb, are you,
you
favor?
Make you make when the, na- the country needs when all around you have. All around
so
you.
So you're
have,
not answering.
No, when you have all around nuclear weapon, you cannot do dabas, isn't that? You have to have strength.
So it's good
you
to
all
have
repeat,
the...
you all repeat strength. Respects.
Strength.
That is the answer to my friend.
So you're in favor of the bomb. Strength, respect,
okay.
Strength.
So
okay, let's ask another, get some other questions. Yes. Here in the front row here, the lady in the striped t-shirt, yes.
Isn't it a problem for the world peace?
Pardon?
When you are in favor of a bomb, isn't it a problem for the world peace?
World peace is very important, okay? How the world peace come? World peace comes on a three-dimensional approach. According to me, I have given a formula. First one, what is the three-dimensional approach for world peace? Education with value system. All you children. For example, when you are studying college, St. Joseph's College, my reverend father, rector, will come. 1 hour every Monday, he will give a lecture on moral science. He will talk to Lord Buddha. He will talk to Augustine. He will talk. And then Khalifa Omar, he will talk about. And then he will talk about Einstein. He will talk about Abraham Lincoln. And their life, how they became great by their way of life. So what is essentially is education with value system. 1 hour in the classroom, every week there should be education with value. I'm propagating throughout wherever I go, I'm propagating.
Are you satisfied with the answer?
No, I have not given the
you're
answer.
Not finished yet, okay.
So answer to your question, there's a three-dimensional approach for peace, okay? This I have propagated.
No, but her question was?
Won't it endanger the world peace?
Will a bomb endanger world peace?
No, that's world peace, poverty.
No, bomb.
Poverty. Poverty and the value system. When there is a country has got a poverty, when the country does not have the value system, when there is a poverty and there is no value system, that is endanger the peace.
So you ask her the question, do you think a bomb will affect...
No, I have convinced her.
A bomb doesn't affect world. Do you think it affects world peace?
Next,
yes, sir,
next
definitely.
Question.
You
next
think
question.
It affects world peace?
Next question.
Yes, sir.
So she's just answering. She thinks
no,
it affects
see,
world peace.
I want to tell you, bomb was there from 1945. Bomb is there. It was never used. Okay?
True.
Do you understand?
Right.
So it is. That's why I gave you a philosophy: strength, respect, strength. Okay? Okay.
So if you have the bomb, there'll be.
No.
You
no,
don't need to use
no.
it.
What I'm saying. Bomb is only one of the elements, but most important thing is I have the three-dimensional approach, world peace. That is education value system,
right.
Transforming religion into a spiritual force, and third is removing the poverty.
We got these young people asking questions. Before they ask the first question, president should be a politician or non-politician?
Hi, what type of question? Fantastic. You know, is a political question or what do you say? Is a political question? Eh? Eh? Yeah, see,
girl,
see, all of them say it's a political question. But I answer
you.
Is, answer is,
yeah.
The president, any president, my experience says, in Rashtrapati Bhavan,
yes.
Each president has brought a core competence. Somebody can be a lawyer, somebody can be a judge, somebody can be an educationalist, somebody a politician. Each one bring the core competence and enrich the Rashtrapati Bhavan. He or she should be a good human being. If a good human being, he will be the best president. Do you agree?
Oh, okay. Can a politician be a good human being?
No, I have answered. I have answered.
Okay, you don't have to answer.
I have answered.
Okay, now the next question. How about who hasn't asked? Okay, the girl in red here in the fourth row.
Good evening, sir.
Yeah, go ask your question.
Good evening, sir. I'm Prerna.
Yeah.
My question is that with Pratibha Patil and Sonia Gandhi as the supreme heads of India today,
India will face a kind of a feminist movement. What is your opinion on it?
You love it. You love it. You know, I personally believe this. When the last 5 years when I was the president, I was provocating with the 50% of the population of women folk. They deserve 33% in parliament. But so far, they have not put forth, the women folk, they have not put forth. If they are 30% in the assembly, state assembly, if they are 33% in the parliament, what change they will do? What change they will do in the parliament? What change they will do legislative assembly? Change means dynamic change.
Right.
This answer, whenever the team of women representatives come to me, that we want 33%, I tell them, you give me this answer.
Did they give you?
Partly, not fully. But you are, since a lot of you are women, girls are here, you must, what I feel in my mind, I want to tell you. You must say, in politics, there are politics I defined in two parts. Politics equal to, one is political politics, another is developmental politics. Okay?